and this is John Craggs. He left for Middlesbrough 11 years ago yesterday, playing the ball forward for Imre Vardy. He's the man with the pace, looking to play the telling ball in, and he's won a corner. Jeff Clark will be going up there to add extra height. Moving up into the box. It'll be Chris Waddle with the corner. Look for it to be swung towards the near post, but it's nodded away. Truick trying to battle in there, and Hucker is down to beat the chance away. And it's Newcastle's turn to apply the pressure, and how St James's Park responds. It was Cartwright in there, making life difficult for the Rangers' defence. And again, Newcastle have the corner. Waddle got it away there by Gregory, helped on by Waddock. They haven't got it clear yet, and Waddle again has the chance to cross. Martin trying to get it over there. It wouldn't come through for Truick. Truick could get the chance to turn on this one. Support from Saunders. Tremendous start by Newcastle United, and they found Imre Vardy. But the referee had spotted offside, I do believe. Truick up there helping out the attack. Remember, it was Truick's feet that had to be cleared before Newcastle could even buy Kevin Keegan. Picked up by Martin. Didn't quite find Vardy. Martin, the deposed Newcastle captain. Larkin there quickly as well. So too was Fenwick. Possession. Gregory Stewart, that was a neat little shimmy there to send him away, and the chance to cross as well. And it nearly bounced off Wes Saunders, who got quite challenging. Newcastle scramble it clear and have the opportunity to break themselves, but that was a dangerous piece of attacking play by Rangers. And it's Vardy on the chase now. Fenwick is policing him there. Vardy's still going, if he can pull it back. Flashed away by Hazel. Certainly the pace of Vardy is proving quite as difficult to handle for the Rangers defence as the threat of Keegan at the moment. I'm sure Vardy, who's had five different striking partners over the past season with Newcastle and was their top scorer, will welcome the extra support he'll get now. Now Waddle can take the free kick. Hazel again challenging for it, so too was Clark. It's come for Cartwright. Celebrate his return to St James's Park with a goal. Began last season as Middlesbrough's captain. Certainly will add tremendous experience and composure to what was last season a very youthful Newcastle side. Chances now. Stainrod deep. Gregory's gone on a run, and it's a good ball from Stainrod. It couldn't find its way through to Gregory, who still hasn't given up the ghost. Haddock there and Saunders. Well, they couldn't quite work the clearance, but they've got the throw in. Keegan and Vardy. Keegan again and Keegan again. Certainly Rangers getting their fair share of the possession in these opening 15 minutes or so. Here Cartwright. He lost a little bit of momentum now, but he's found John Craggs in support on the right. Broke then. Wor appeals for offside. He was away with some pace. Cut inside, but Hucker was working out his angles all along. I think he was looking for the supporting man arriving, but when he went it alone, Hucker was there. A bit of limping there from John Truitt, but I'm sure he doesn't want to come off a game like this afternoon's. Will come on. In fact, obviously, just a few steps proving to Truitt that he couldn't continue. We'll have to wait till there's a break in play. Into Truitt's midfield role. Cox looking fairly impassive despite the excitement of the afternoon. He's really beaving away this first half, doing a splendid job. But Rangers with this young side, by no means over a white suit, and I wonder just how long it is since that particular regalia has had an airing at St James's Park, but certainly the wear of it looks in remarkable metal. Craggs Steve Hardwick. Keegan's flick. Dawes. See Stewart. And Jeff Clark there. A bit too casual perhaps, but he's got a second go. Was in an offside position and play brought back. But Jeff Clark, who was always right to come surging forward, will certainly have enjoyed that, I think. So too did the crowd. Keegan setting up Waddle. Knew it. Hucker immediately looked towards the linesman. Waddle thinking and trying to work the opening. It was a good ball as Ferrari was through on the side as they all waited, but he couldn't really make the opportunity tell. Waddock. Cartwright. Minutes gone in the second half, and still we await the first goal of the 82-83 season here at St James's Park. And the crowd beginning to respond again to try and lift Newcastle. Harry Waddock getting the tackle in.
Jeff Clark stayed up with the attack as it comes out wide for Chris Waddle.
push that one away to safety. But it's a corner to Newcastle. Waddle will take it. Keegan challenging, but Hucker collects. Luck on the right now. It's a poor one though, and it's City and Stewart away. Stainrod now, good return ball. Stewart's continued. He's only got Seeley in the middle, a little bit of support arriving now, but he's had to check back. Stainrod now. Away there by Craggs. Waddock. Just in defence, oh, high shot from Gregory, and Steve Harding just about got his body behind that one, but what a good snap shot. Newcastle defence was living dangerously then, never really convincingly cleared it. There was a miss kick by Haddock and it fell to Gregory and he blasted it, and Steve Hardwick just about held on. Now Mick Martin for Newcastle, and he's onside. Peter Cartwright, they've got three men spare here in the middle, they can get the ball in. Waddle, keeper. Was a golden opportunity squandered by Newcastle. Three in a line there onside. Cartwright was the man who sprung the trap originally. Played the ball into the middle. The first man there was Waddle, and over the top it went. But credit to Hucker, who came out to close it down. In there, calls for Keegan, brings it down, and finds Waddle in one movement. Now Mick Martin to Verardi, he's onside, but he couldn't take the chance, he just delayed that fraction, and that was all Peter Hucker needed. That was a fine chance for him, Ray Verardi, to really put this game beyond all doubt. Played forward there by Mick Martin. Seemed to wait for the offside decision, but Mr. Mills signalled quite clearly he was all right, and Hucker pulled it back.
Kevin, a remarkable day, and to score the only goal of the game, a remarkable ending to it.
Well, if the people have enjoyed the sounds half as much as I have today, then we're all happy. Tremendous, it's fairy tale stuff. QPR made it very difficult. They're a good side. They're the sort of quality of side we're going to have to beat if we're going to get promotion. And first half, I thought they deserved, if anything, to go up, probably be in front. But once we got on top in the second half. We could have won 4 or 5 in the end, so we showed a tremendous amount of character. I thought Jeff Clark at the back was unbelievable, and Craggsy and the young lads, they covered every bit of ground, you know, which we can give them the experience, and if they can give us the legs, then we've got a recipe for success. So
what about the goal as well, because it was very well worked with Ray Berardi?
Well, you know, I hope, I said to Ray afterwards, he did brilliant for me, and I hope next week I can do the same for him. I flicked it on and just turned, and once he knocked it in the space, it was one against the keeper, and I think he did everything he could to make it difficult for me, but I just managed to squeeze it in, and the crowd sucked it in. You know, I only just tapped it, and they sucked it right in the net. It was a great feeling, and you know, it's one of those. I didn't want to come out of the crowd; I just wanted to stay there forever. I was tired, you see. I was quite happy when the lad held on to me. I said, "Keep hold of me, whatever you do."
Can I just take you back to your entrance into the St James's Park Arena? What really was going through your mind when you walked out onto the pitch?
Well, obviously, people had said all week, you know, you're never going to know anything like this. So I knew it was going to be something special, but it surprised me even more than I thought it would. Yeah, incredible noise, you know, deafening. And the amazing thing about St James's Park compared with other grounds is that in Liverpool you get it from the cop, but at St James's Park it comes from everywhere. So it's like stereo almost, you know, with four speakers. It's I've never known anything like it. Obviously, when Malcolm made his debut 11 years ago, we're playing against him. You try and shove it out of your mind, but when you know the four, it's a different thing. And they won us the game in the end. They kept us going when we needed it. We didn't have a particularly good first half, but as I say, that's what great supporters are all about. They can win you games that sometimes you don't deserve to win.
Fans who've worshipped him these past two seasons. Fittingly, wife Jean and daughters Laura Jane and Sarah Marie were there to share the occasion with a grateful and adoring public. But Liverpool did put something of a damper on the celebrations when Mike Robinson latched onto a Graham Souness pass to shoot the league champions ahead after 20 minutes. For a friendly, the game had a decidedly competitive edge, and Newcastle pressure led to Craig Johnson palming over a Keegan header. Referee Pat Partridge spotted the offence, and guess who stepped up to take the spot kick? The script didn't allow for Keegan to miss. Liverpool, and Mark Lawrenson in particular, made sure the great man didn't have it all his own way. But we thought we were en route to a fairy tale ending when Keegan beat Grubble out of the ball to put United in front. Sadly, the linesman's flag was up and the goal was disallowed. 5 minutes before the break and Liverpool were ahead again. Kevin Carr saved from Dalglish, Craig Johnson met the rebound, and David McCreary's attempted block fell just right for Graham Souness. Keegan's old team led 2-1 at the interval, and as the band marched on, his parting gift to the people of Newcastle went on display. This £6,000 minibus will carry underprivileged kids to future United games. With his time and a black and white shirt ebbing away, the fans were willing Keegan to score whenever he had the ball, but Grobbelaar had his reputation to think about. United's equaliser came from this Terry McDermott special. And while that was just about the end of the action on the pitch, Keegan's final curtain call was still to come. Colour, spectacle and emotion, his last moments had the lot.
Sad. I know it's over, but life goes on, and this old world will keep on turning. Let's just be glad we had some time to spend together. There's no need to watch the bridges that were burning. Lay your head upon my pillow. Hold your warm and tender body close to mine.
You know, I get the impression he's going to be sadly missed. That's it for tonight. We'll see you again on Monday. I'll see some of you on Sunday. Back to Super Kev.
Make believe you love me one more time. For the good times.